Hi guys, welcome to the channel. My name is Martin, this is Lego Fan UK, and I am super excited to bring to you this video of this awesome little brick sketches set that's just been released. I've got hold of all four, and I want to get this one done first. This is a Joker. Its set number is 40428. It's on sale for £17.99, and it includes 170 pieces. Now, I wanted to do this one first because I wanted to be able to build this and actually see what's going on with the face, how they've actually done this as a brick sketch frame, and we'll also have a look and see how you can display it or hang it. The box is really cool, quite simple, similar to the brick heads writing up here. So we've got brick sketches. Looks like someone's got a paintbrush and slapped that across there. So they've like obviously little marks missing, so it looks like someone just painted that. And this one's quite cool because it's like also a purpley colour, which obviously matches the Joker's clothes that he wears. You've got the DC and the Batman symbol there as well. On the top, we have a one-to-one comparison of size, so that's a 4x2 slope. And then we'll spin it round. And on the back, we have it displayed on the wall and on a sideboard, so it shows the back here, and also the build in progress. So the cool thing here is we've got tabs at the top, rather than those silly little finger pull-out bits, which I absolutely hate. Oops, so I use a knife there to open that. It's a bit sharp, so be careful, guys, if you're opening with a knife like that. Open this up and have a look, see what we got. Loads of green bits. So we've got one bag of green bits, a bag of long pieces and some flat tiles, so that's quite cool to see. And then we've got a bag of small elements, and then another bag of even smaller elements. So that's quite a different way of packaging. There's no numbers on those bags. My book is an absolute pigsty of a mess, but I don't care, I'm gonna build it. And then it's got about the designer, so Chris McVeigh, who obviously didn't work for Lego, so I worked for them and put this idea into progress. Manual is a little bit on the flimsy side. It's really thin paper. But it is a total of 57 pages, or if we include the build, it's 55 pages and 53 stages. So, guys, let's get this built. Super excited, and we'll have a review at the end to see what we think of this. So guys, there we have it. It was actually a really good, fun little build. Not a lot of pieces, but you can see it's quite good. I absolutely love this. I love the way this looks. The teeth section was absolutely really good. Very different way of doing it, using a snot brick technique to obviously get these flat pieces on there, the tiles. The nose looks really good as well. And I love how they've done the eyebrows. So actually, it's really, really cool. Would say it's probably about the right size I thought it was going to be. I didn't think it was going to be anything massive. But you can imagine a whole row of these on your wall. They're actually really good. So that's obviously from the front. You can see where the light's shining at the moment. You can see, obviously, the contour of his face. It is, including the frame, you're looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, technically 7, maybe 8 layers thick. So actually, it's really cool. I love how I've done a little bow tie, just using 2 cheese slopes. The nose is good and the eyes are pretty cool. If you watched the build, you would have seen the eyes look really strange until you put these sort of flat 2x3 tiles on there. But it's really cool. I'm going to show you a side profile. And that side profile is actually quite good. You can see obviously the nose sticking out, the eyebrows and the lips as well. The cheeks are slightly out here as well. And then the eyes are indented. Slight brow raised up and then obviously the hair. So it's actually quite a clever way of doing it because it's contoured like a face. So if you're side viewing a face, it's almost contoured like that. If you imagine if they built the background, you know, it'd be like one of the helmets basically. But no, that's really cool. As you see as well, it stands really well without the actual little stand on the back. So we'll have a look at the back. You've got a little eyelet hole here. So it's a 2x2 modified tile. So you can hang it on the wall. Just need a little pin pitch frame. Obviously, there's not a lot of weight to it. So it'll hang really well on any type of wall. And then using these Technic bars and these sort of like macaroon loops, you've got a little stand. So you can actually stand it at a slight angle. So when you display it, it looks like that. And if you angle it up, it's bit higher, but you can't really go much higher. You can put it a little bit flatter if you want to, but personally I think probably that sort of height is probably the best if you're going to have it on a mantelpiece or on a sideboard. But like that on a wall, it's going to look really good on a wall. Now what I think is going to be quite cool is if we have a lot of these, is get them all next to each other with no gaps between, all buttoned up together. I think that'll look really, really cool. Thank you for watching the video, guys. If it's your first time here, please click that subscribe button, hit that bell notification, keep up date with my latest videos. Don't forget, I also have the other 3 to build, so I'm going to try and upload those as soon as I can. So keep an eye out for those as well, guys. But anyway, thank you for watching the video, guys. Take care yourselves, and I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.